Yeah, the other day we tried to lower the temperature inside the incubator units, and we found a drying rate, dehumidification rate is a little faster than we expected, and we concluded that we doubt the bent fans, which is located on the door face and the right-hand side of each incubator unit, are not completely closed. So just in case, if you could check all the fan caps are turned to clockwise and hard stop, there are four bent caps. That would be great.
For both micro G and 1G unit?
Affirmative. And figure 7 would be a good photo for your understanding.
Checking.
And sub fan cap, the fan caps are on the micro G side. Looks okay. And all of the four fan caps are turned hard stop. That'll be fine.
Yes, Shimamiya-san, I can confirm all four fan units caps tightened, and I can see all triangle alignment marks aligned.
Okay, sounds like perfect. Thank you very much for extra checking.
Welcome. Thank you very much. お疲れ様でした.
お疲れ様です. Talk to you soon.
Boston Station on Face the Ground 2 for PS120 for airlock plug-in plan.
Go on, 2.
Hey, I've been looking a little while in PMM Port 1 Rack Bay for 2.0 CTV 4045. I don't seem to find it and was wondering if you've got an alternate location for another PS120.
Checking. We'll get back to you.
All right, we'll keep pressing on Beam while you're waiting for that. And just wondering if there's any dependency on this plug-in plan for some activities that Talk is doing, if that needs to be done by a certain time.
Checking. And Kate Houston's back with you on 2. Whenever you're ready, I've got a previously known location for that CTB 4045. No rush.
I'm ready to copy.
Okay, Kate, before it moved to this P1 location, we were tracking it as PMM1 overhead 4, Golf 1.
Okay, I'll look there as well, and just wondering if that's the only PS120 or if you guys have another place to look for the PS120 if we can't find the CTB.
Yep, we'll look into the answer for that one. And then to answer your other question, Talk needs this PS120 setup before the big airway monitoring setup activity that starts at 11.
Okay, copy. We'll get this in work. Thank you.
Houston Station on 2 for TOCA.
Go ahead, on 2.
We're ready to get started. Wondering if you guys could take care of steps 1 and 2 for us.
And those are complete.
All right. Thank you, Houston.
Munich Station on Spacecom 2 for annual sensor changeout.
Good morning, Tech. This is Munich Spacecom 2, and we are with you for the annual sensor changeout.
Hey, good morning. I have completed activity and sensor serial number 1016 is installed to a high NO analyzer, and serial number 1017 was installed onto a low NO analyzer.
And TAC, this is Munich, that's a perfect configuration. Thanks for the feedback.
Okay, and talk to you later.
Talk to you later.
Houston station on Space to Ground 2 for PS120. I was able to find that PS120 serial number 1017 in node 2. It was not. It was next to the OP, but was not plugged in and doesn't have anything plugged into it. So if you guys agree, I can go ahead and use this PS120 to set up the airway monitoring experiment.
Checking, Kate.
Station on Space Ground 2, GEM camcorder is ready for downlink.
Okay, Tech, downlink is ready. Thank you very much.
And Kate, Houston's back with you on two.
With you on two.
Okay, so the big picture answer is yes, you are more than welcome to use that junction box 1017 that you found. That's a good find. In that CTB that you cannot find, however, we're also tracking that you need a PS120 cable that's 10 feet long. Can you tell us, is there anything attached to the junction box that you found?
Yes, there is a PS120 cable attached to the junction box. It's a 5-foot cable, but when I set this up the last time, the PS120 can go right next to the UOP, so the 5-foot cable should fit no problem.
Okay, I understand. That's great news. So take that 5-foot cable with you for the setup, and we'll talk some more down here on if we think you actually need the 10-foot for some other reason. And just a little bit more background on this CTB 4045. Not to point any fingers, but you're the last one to use it. It was said back
in
August.
I looked like three times before I called you guys, but I can't find it.
No problem. No problem at all. Just wanted to give you that data that you were the last one to touch it, and the activity was to put it in that port one location. So if you can't find it there, then we'll keep digging around in our records.
My plan is when we got a little bit more time to pull everything out of port one and then also just check the starboard one bay. It's probably there. I remember the bag being pretty small, and so it may have slipped down into back behind the end cone somewhere. And I just wanted to make sure we get this activity set up and don't delay TOX airway monitoring setup. So I will attempt to find it. This is mine.
No problem at all, Kate. And Flight Director Ed says your reputation's on the line with this one.
Oh, shoot. I better do it now.
I was going to say it might be a good handover task.
Oh, that's brilliant. All right. We'll call Shane to help out. Thank you, guys.
Station on Space Ground 2 for IPVI.
Go ahead for IPVI.
Step 2 decimal 4, I checked the right sound as well as auto focus. Checked, and also right light is also selected. Should I deselect it? Right sound and auto focus.
OK,
okay, got it, and please deselect, remove the check.
station on Spaceground 2 for IPVI. Step 2.6.6 is complete.
Okay, step 2.6.6 is complete. Intact to be on the same page. Step 3 will be not going to be complete this time.
Thanks for the reminder.